Welcome to another episode from the Financial Controller, where we dive into real-life accounting cases. If there is a company out there that's cooking the books, we will be showcasing it right here on this channel. After discussing each case, I will give it a score from 1 to 10, which is a range from clean accounting, aggressive accounting, cooking the books, all the way to straight-up fraud. Today's case is a company that's been around since 1893. That's over a century. And if you live in the United States or Canada, you'll be familiar with them. Waste Management, the trash collection company. In the 1990s, the company was embroiled in a host of accounting malpractice issues, such as inflating the useful life of their trucks and not taking any write-downs on their landfills. Just to give you an idea of the magnitude of this case, this crisis cut the company's stock price in half in a few short weeks. But first, a brief history. The company was founded by Harm Huizinga, I hope I'm pronouncing the name right here, which was a Dutch immigrant who began hauling garbage for $1.25 in a wagon in Chicago. Then, in 1968, Wayne Huizinga, who is the grandson, founded Waste Management Inc. and went on a buying spree, picking up smaller garbage collection firms left and right, consolidating his profitable yet a bit smelly empire. In 1971, Waste Management went public, and by 72, the company had made 133 acquisitions and $82 million in annual revenue. It had 60,000 commercial and industrial accounts and 600,000 residential customers in 19 states. I surely remember seeing their trucks by my house as a kid in New York City. So up until the early 1990s, things were going well. The stock price was growing and the company was expanding by acquiring local profitable trash collection companies. In 1992, the management team got just a little bit greedy and wanted to line their pockets with extra cash from bonuses and stock compensation. So they resorted to a few accounting techniques to increase profits. According to a lawsuit filed by the SEC, the company reduced its depreciation expense by doing two things. One, inflating the useful life of its trucks, as well as increasing the salvage value. In plain English, the company was required to recognize the cost of the trucks on a straight line basis over a certain period of time. By increasing that period of time and implying a higher residual value for the trucks, the periodic expense recognized will be less. Secondly, the company reduced the cost it recognized on the depletion of its landfills by refusing to take write-downs of their remaining useful life. See, with landfills, just like machinery and trucks, the company needs to recognize its cost of depreciation, or in this case, depletion. This is because, as you might imagine, a landfill will have a definite life, and you can't just go on using it forever. Normally, you'll need to take a write-off or expense these capitalized assets. But the company didn't and went against generally accepted accounting principles. As if all of this wasn't enough, the company also failed to write off impaired assets carried on its balance sheet, improperly capitalized interest and other current period expenses, and understated its income tax expenses. In total, the company misrepresented their expenses in the tune of $1.7 billion. That's billion with a B. Obviously, when this news came out, a class action lawsuit was filed on behalf of everyone and those entities that purchased the company's stock or sold put options from June 1998 to November 1999. Waste Management settled and paid $457 million. Again, that's $457 million in settlement. Its management team was fired and ordered to pay collectively about $35 million in fines just paid by its management team personally. And the CFO and the controller were ordered not to hold the same roles ever again in publicly traded companies. You might be wondering, what about the auditors? What did they say about all of this? Well, guess who was the audit firm that was asleep at the wheel here? I'll give you a hint. It's the same accounting firm that was asleep at the wheel as Enron auditors. You guessed it, Arthur Andersen. Arthur Andersen found errors in Waste Management books and records and came up with adjustments and recommended them to management. The officers of Waste Management refused to take these adjustments that Arthur Anderson proposed. And in order for them to keep them silent, the management team bribed Arthur Anderson by telling them that they would receive additional fees outside of the agreement they originally made. Arthur Anderson, in turn, issued an unqualified opinion, which is, in plain language, a clean audit opinion for the audit report for Waste Management, and wrote off the accounting errors over time in order to conceal the fraud. Not only was Waste Management committing fraud with their accounting books, but now they are also committing illegal acts by bribing Arthur Anderson. In fact, Arthur Anderson wasn't just any sort of auditing firm to the stakeholders of Waste Management. James Koenig, who was a CFO of Waste Management, was trained at Arthur Anderson as an auditor. Thomas Howe, who was the chief accounting officer of Waste Management, was also trained at Arthur Anderson as an auditor, and he was a partner there for 30 years, and as well as being the engagement partner for the Waste Management account. Also, Bruce Tupickson, who was the Vice President of Finance of Waste Management, was the Audit Manager of Waste Management Inc. Audit and others at Arthur Anderson. These important executives at Waste Management all came from Arthur Anderson, who was the company in charge of the audit of Waste Management. Arthur Anderson ended up being fined for $7 million for the entirety of the Waste Management scandal. But we all know that 3 years later, in 2002, Arthur Anderson collapsed along with Enron. I'm going to put a link here and in the description below to my video on the Enron case, so please make sure you watch that as well. And like I said at the start of the video, we will rate this case on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being clean accounting and 10 being fraud. In this case, it's pretty obvious. Waste Management started by cooking the books when they manipulated the useful life of their trucks. But then things moved from cooking the books to fraud when they refused to make adjustments recommended by the auditor, and even bribing them to keep them quiet. Luckily for Waste Management, after paying a massive $457 million fine, the company was able to rebound and flourish in the years after that, having learned a very, very valuable and expensive lesson. How about you? I hope you learned a thing or two from this video. If so, please give a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel so that you don't miss out on any of the videos that I put out weekly. Also, please consider sharing this video with someone who you might think will appreciate this interesting accounting case, and I will see you in the next video.